Look at this beautiful, beautiful trout. This river is filled with them, and they are normally this size. But from time to time you find some bigger ones. This is where I grew up. A friend asked me once how many hours I spent in this river, but after thinking about it, it's not hours, it's thousands of weeks or days, thousands of days. I mean, it's I know this river very well. I've been here all my youth, almost every day, fishing and camping and building huts and all this. And this is a beautiful, beautiful area. Can you see the mountains all around? And this river goes 3 kilometers down and maybe 2 kilometers from here and ends up in the ocean. And at the bottom of this river, the salmon also come up, so it's a lovely place. And I'm back here on holiday now, so and my family went out shopping, so I thought I could go fishing. So I'll take you along on a little journey in my old backyard. Beautiful, eh? You see this old cabin? It's a friend of mine and myself built this for 25 years. It's 25 years since we built this, and it's still standing. We built this beside this lake, or this pond, because it's also a very good fishing pond, and not so many people knew about it because it's isolated from the roads and everything. You can't see this from anywhere. You have to walk the river or walk through the forest to find it. So in here we will get some fish, and in here we might find some bigger ones, because this river comes from a mountain lake which has pretty big trouts, and from time to time some of them follow the rivers down and end up in this bigger ponds like this one. So we'll try. Beautiful, tastes good, but a little bit small. Well, to get going, I have to go back same way or climb up this way. And I think I have to try the last one. Because it's awful way down. I found this dry spot here, you see? It's so dry underneath this ledge. So, and I also could find a little bit of dry wood. As you can see, this is almost like a rainforest or a jungle, and there are not much dry firewood when it's raining like this. You have to take a big dry log like the one up there and split it and use the centroids. That's the only way. But I might be able to make a little coffee fire with this, so I'll try. With this type of weather, a fire disc is really, really good. Stupid as I was, I took out my kettle to get some room for fishing there. Stupid. That was stupid. I will blow a cup of coffee now. Well, as you see, it's possible to even find some, to make a small fire even when it's raining like this. It sure helps to have some special tinder, of course. It's really good to be back. To be back in this area. That's good, eh? Well, I made it to the top. And I'm gonna show you the view. Look at this. Beautiful river. And when it's dry, we used to jump this. Now it's so slippery, I'm not even gonna try. Okay guys, it's still raining and I've been fishing for a while and haven't got anything else than just typical small trouts. I put them back, all of them. I'm hunting for these bigger ones, but well, I have to stop fishing now. It's some family activity this evening. So I have to go back. It's still a 3 kilometer hike back by this road, so just have to go. So, but I hope you enjoyed taking part of this small fishing trip in my old backwoods. This is where I spent most of my time. Fishing, camping, and all this bushcrafting. I didn't know what bushcraft was then, but apparently I have been doing it a lot of years. So, well, see you in the next one. Might do some more fun. And once again, Ed, thank you for this poncho. I really saved my ass today. It's very wet. So, bye bye.